It was a very close second place finish for Charles Djou in the race for Honolulu mayor this past Saturday. Less than 1% separated him from the incumbent mayor. So what are his thoughts and how is he getting ready for the general election? He joins us now in studio to talk about it. Good morning again.
Good morning. Well, thank you very much for having me on.
Yes. Yeah. So you said back on Saturday, it's time to hit the reset button. What does that include in preparing for the general?
Well, Chrissy, on the first, we're very, very excited. We went up against the incumbent mayor who had 4 years in office. He heavily outspent us. We had an all-volunteer crew, and we basically battled him to a draw. But now we look forward to going on to the general election. We look forward to sharply contrasting the mayor, having made numerous promises and broken all of them here. He never has been consistent on any of the numbers regarding the rail system. We have major problems with ethics, with infrastructure, with homelessness, and we look forward to contrasting our new approach versus what he's done as mayor as we go into the general election.
Now, speaking of rail, he has said, and he's mentioned it a short time ago here in Wake Up Today, that rail has been the only issue that you've been talking about. Is that true?
Well, you know, I think I've been talking about all of these issues here, and really at its core, it's trust. It's about who the people of the city and county of Honolulu should trust to be their next mayor. The current mayor, I mean, everything he says has been just simply wrong. And just the biggest illustration of that breakdown in trust has been the mayor's horrible mismanagement and incompetent handling of the rail system. But it goes beyond rail, and you're absolutely right here. It goes to extend to include ethics about the mayor, I mean, basically railroading the city ethics director when the ethics director started asking the wrong questions about the mayor's political fundraising, trying to get him out of office, making him do things like record his time in 6-minute increments. And today, as Peter Carlisle has stated, ethics has been completely eviscerated. And I think the people deserve a mayor to whom we really can trust and has integrity, and who is going to tell it like it is on the rail system, on homelessness, on infrastructure.
Now, you mentioned Peter Carlisle. How do you get his supporters to vote for you, and how do you get people to vote, period, when we had a record low voter turnout this year?
Yes. Now, first, in terms of Peter Carlisle, I very much look forward to engaging Peter's voters and his supporters. I worked very well with him when he was a city prosecutor and I was a member of the Honolulu City Council. He's a man of remarkable integrity. Although he and I may have had some differences on policy issues, I think he and I have a basic core understanding that government is something that you need a level of integrity, trust, and respect. And that's something to which I will work very, very hard to earning, hopefully, Peter Carlisle's support, but that is support of his voters. In terms of going into the general election, yes, Chrissy, I am disappointed that this primary election had historic low voter turnout, but I am excited looking forward to the general election. Usually much more people turn out for the general than in the primary. There's going to be a broader electorate, and one of the things that excites me is that we are building a very broad coalition of Democrats, Republicans, Independents in my campaign. You can see it ranging from my campaign chairs, Walter Heen, the former chairman of the Democratic Party of Hawaii. I think that broad coalition is going to work very, very well for us in the general election.
Okay, and now we're seeing a video from Saturday night from Pearl Country Club. As soon as you walked in after the second printout, and again, you said that those numbers were very encouraging despite trailing all night. You said that showed that within 2 months, you could go up and up with the incumbent.
Yes, absolutely here. You know, we pulled this campaign just slightly over 2 months. And again, I really want to emphasize, we were very heavily outspent, and my campaign was entire 100% voter and volunteer run. We didn't have any paid staff, no paid consultants, and yet going up against the mayor with his entire machinery of the city government, the fact that he has the power of incumbency, all of the appointees, and that he heavily outspent us, probably by at least 5-1, maybe as much as 7-1 when the numbers come through, and battling him to a draw, I think speaks volumes about the need for change here in our community and the desire of the people to see a real new mayor to whom they can trust.
All right. Thank you so much, Charles Djou, for joining us, and good luck in the general.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate it.